I'm Dr. Ari Brown, and I'm here to talk about vaccines. What shots do your kids need, and why are they important? Vaccines provide protection, or immunity, to certain viral and bacterial infections that can cause serious illness and death. Vaccines work by revving up the body's immune system to make antibodies that recognize a particular germ and fight it off. And thank goodness vaccines are so effective. These diseases are not ones you ever want your child to have. As a result of universal vaccination, smallpox has been completely eliminated and polio is rare in most parts of the world. And vaccines have significantly reduced the incidence of the top three causes of bacterial meningitis. Infections like measles, diphtheria, and tetanus that used to sicken and kill children are unfamiliar to most parents today. But other than smallpox, these infections still exist, and outbreaks still occur, particularly in under-vaccinated communities. If more than 10% of American parents choose to opt out of vaccines, our entire country would see these horrible diseases return. Fortunately, over 99% of American parents do vaccinate their children. Your newborn gets his very first vaccine, hepatitis B, in the first hours or days of life. But the rest of the routine vaccination series starts at 2 months of age, with additional shots at 4 months, 6 months, 12, 15, and 18 months. And some booster shots are given between 4 and 6 years old to maintain long-term protection. Yes, it is a lot of shots. Yes, there are more shots than you and I got as kids, but that is a good thing. Even though the number of shots has gone up, a child's immune system actually has less work to do to mount a protective response. That's because today's vaccines are smarter and safer. A vaccine, like any other medication, has a small chance of causing an adverse reaction. Most side effects are minor, like a slight fever, fussiness, or temporary redness of the skin. The risk of having a serious event, like an allergic reaction, is about 1 in 1 million, and the benefits definitely outweigh the risks. Pain medications like acetaminophen can help ease the discomfort that comes with getting shots. But giving a dose before or shortly after those shots may limit the body's immune response to the vaccine. That's why many pediatricians suggest waiting a few hours after those shots to give your child a dose of medicine. Don't worry, your baby will probably have an easier time getting those shots than you will watching it. But you can feel better knowing you are doing your best protect your little one.